ArtBeach presents Encore at Home, Enhancing Accessible Experiences in Arts and Culture, featuring Philadelphia's Magic Gardens.
Hi, everyone. I'm Olivia, the Education and Outreach Manager at Philadelphia's Magic Gardens, and that's where I'm talking to you from today. So you might not know what Philadelphia's Magic Gardens is, but we are a museum and an art environment. I'm going to tell you a little bit more about what that is and how this place came to be. So I'm standing in the middle of our outdoor sculpture garden, and what you see around me are different colored bottles, there's bricks, there's bicycle wheels, there's broken plates, there's even a toilet. There are mosaics behind me, and the artwork really is all around. So it's on the walls beside me that go up about 8 feet. It's on the floor below me, and it's completely surrounding me. It's on pretty much every surface. So this was all created by one artist. His name is Isaiah Zagar, and he started working on this site in about 1991. But before this, he had worked on lots of other sites. So his home is also fully decorated like this. He owns a few other buildings with his wife, Julia, and they're also decorated. But this is really his biggest project. So Isaiah started working on these lots here after he had been working on his art studio, which was right next to this space in the building that's still part of Philadelphia's Magic Gardens, where our indoor galleries currently are. And Isaiah started moving onto the outside lots, the first of which he owned. The second two of the three he did not own. And those were really just abandoned lots. The owners did not live in Philadelphia, and they were not taking care of them. So they're like a lot of places you might see in the city. They were covered with dirt and weeds and trash, and no one was cleaning them up. So Isaiah decided he was going to clean them up, and then he was going to start beautifying them. He was going to start putting art there, which is what Isaiah does on pretty much any space that he has access to. So he was doing that little by little for years until 2004, when the owners came back to this space and they saw what Isaiah had started here. It wasn't by any stretch of the imagination what we see here now, but it was just the beginnings of that. And they said that they didn't think this was art. They thought it was trash, and they wanted it off of their property. So they told Isaiah he could either buy the lots, which he didn't have the money to do, or they were going to have everything knocked down at his expense. So neither of those were really great options, but what happened was the community really came to Isaiah's rescue. So people started donating money, they were volunteering their time, there were lawyers who got involved and were working for free. And that group of people, along with Isaiah Zagar, were able to form the nonprofit Philadelphia's Magic Gardens in 2004, in October of that year. And that was when Isaiah really had permission to be on the site, and this became his main project. So that's when he started building these hallways that are all around me. He started actually excavating below. So I'm standing on street level, but there's actually a whole level of the Magic Gardens that goes below the street that is below my feet, where he and workers dug out what had been the foundations of the buildings that had been here previously. And so there's all different ways that you can go when you're here in the outdoor sculpture garden at Philadelphia's Magic Gardens. And he worked on this part of the site for about 4 years, where he was really working on this every day. This was his main project until 2008, when we opened in the way that we are now, as a museum with paid staff members and regular hours where visitors can come in and explore the space and be inspired by the artwork here. So I know you can't come visit Philadelphia's Magic Gardens right now, but you can take a virtual tour on our website anytime from the comfort of your home. And we hope you'll be back to visit us really soon. We're waiting for the day when we can have lots more people in the space exploring and being inspired by the artwork. So thanks very much for listening, and hope to see you at Philadelphia's Magic Gardens soon.
Support by Independence Public Media Foundation. ASL interpretation by Hands Up Productions. Special thanks to Olivia Edlund of Philadelphia's Magic Gardens, James Caverly, our deaf talent, and the Virginia and Harvey Kimmel Family Education Fund. Learn more at www.art-reach.org.